Thank you, Toastmaster, for that wonderful introduction. It doesn't matter how much speech you gave before, icebreaker is always icebreaker. It will bring fear in your face instantly. The moment you heard the word, it's icebreaker. Let me ask you something. How many of you had the fear of public speaking? Or at least had the fear of public speaking before joining Toastmaster? Any guess what is the data from the world, rest of the world?
99.
It's 74%, but the number of hands seems to be more than 74%. And it has been verified from the National Institute of Mental Health. And this very reason of overcoming public speaking is speaking in front of new faces endangered a reason for me to be here, to overcome that very reason. To talk in front of new people. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmaster and dear guest.
Good afternoon.
We all make choices in our life, and at the end, our choices make us. As a 10-year-old kid, I made an important decision. Not to run away from house, to get into a boarding school, JNV Murshidabad. It's not difficult to realize what you are leaving behind. And few days into the school taught me an important thing that I am miles away from my home, my sweet home. Since then, I've enjoyed 13 years of hostel life. Certainly not the hostel food. You can guess why I'm skinny. If you eat 13 years of hostel food, you will die. When I sat down sometimes, reminiscing those good old days from school times, few things that always comes to my mind, that sparked my mind, is using rough work the park with Parker paint. Have you ever in your life used a Parker paint to do a rough work? Well, those are not my pens. All of them are stolen from principal's office. I was probably the most naughtiest kid in the school, killing the aquarium fish, feeding them more than what they required, stealing pens, doing rough work, and keeping them exactly at the same place when the ink is over. We always hated our seniors, our immediate seniors. Still, I do. Once they have the pre-board exam, we were in 9th standard that time, and we decided, our group of friends, 4 or 5 friends, we're going to steal their food from their rooms. If you can eat it, eat it. If you can't eat, throw it in dustbin. Just steal the food. And guess what? We did it. After that schooling, I went on to AMU for my higher education, higher secondary schooling, moving to a different linguistic state from a Bengali to Hindi was a mixed experience for me. If you believe me, even Mamata Banerjee was to speak better Hindi than me at that time. Learning Hindi was a fun thing for me. I felt like I'm going to school again. After that comes the engineering life, the life we enjoyed the most, probably. Due to certain reason, I ended up in a college I never wanted to, MNNIT Allahabad. That too with a discipline I always hated, electronics and communication engineering. But in the very first day of college, I came to know that there is something called internal sliding. If you can perform well academically, at the end of the year, you can change your discipline. My favorite discipline was computer science and engineering. So I was galvanized with that idea, and I was excited and all those things. I ran into one of my senior and asked me, what it really takes to slide your branch? And he was like, smiling at me, nodding my head, hey kiddo, it's not that easy to score 9.6 here in college. It's no more school now. That felt terrible. But that doesn't mean that I should stop trying in the first place. I tried, I studied well, and in that process I distanced myself from all the fun activities from college. In the process of completing my mission to change my branch, even I was mocked by one of my professors I hated the most from the workshop department. He went on to told me, "You are a disgrace to this college. You don't deserve to be here. If I had the power, I should throw you out of this college." I was in despair at that time. I really don't know what to do. There is two options for me. Either I quit, go back and sleep, or work hard and harder. And I wanted to top that semester. Just to prove him wrong, I'm not a piece of garbage. Adolf Hitler once rightly said, "If you win, you need not have to explain. If you lose, you shouldn't be there to explain." I was sleeping, my favorite thing, and my friend came and told me, "Congratulations, your branch is computer science and engineering, and you are a physical medalist. Please book a restaurant, we want a treat from you." Apart from all this schooling life, I just love sleeping. I had a track record of sleeping 36 hours in a row. Just water in between after 7-8 hours. I'm too freak about watching football matches that even I ended up watching a football match giving my Oracle third round of interview. The company I'm placed finally. I love Formula One just because of Ferrari. It's red, Italian car. Throughout my career, all the struggles, all the mocking, I've come to learn a very important lesson. Don't question yourself. Don't let somebody tell you can't do something, not even yourself. And always remember, as Muhammad Ali said, "It's not the mountain ahead of you that wear you out, it's the pebbles in your shoes." Over to you, Professor.